Hey everyone, in this tutorial we're going to take a look at how you can animate your MetaHuman characters in Unreal Engine 5 via iClone 8. There are some notable updates in the latest version which will help to improve the workflow and make the process much easier, which we'll explore here. You can find out more information about the MetaHuman LiveLink workflow from the ReLusion website landing page, where you'll find the plugin as well as some additional resources. If you already have iClone and the Unreal LiveLink plugin, please download the MetaHuman LiveLink kit and ensure that you're using the matching versions. You will also find dedicated installation and introductory tutorials on our ReLusion courses page. In Unreal, you'll want to make sure that you have the iClone LiveLink and Quixel Bridge plugins installed and activated. Make sure to double check that they're activated from the plugin window. You'll want to ensure that you have at least a single MetaHuman target in your Unreal Engine project to start off, as the data is required to activate LiveLink. So let's open up Quixel Bridge and proceed to import in our MetaHuman character. Simply download and then add to your current project, and your MetaHuman character will be added to its own dedicated folder in the content drawer. Within the downloaded iClone MetaHuman LiveLink kit, you'll find a 3DX profile, as well as a content folder, which includes some blueprints and a MetaHuman Dummies folder that includes corresponding eye avatars for all of the different MetaHuman body types. The 3DX profile is used for pose correction in Character Creator 4, which we'll discuss in a separate tutorial. Okay, the first thing we want to do is copy the two content subfolders we just saw to the content folder of our Unreal project. You'll want to ensure that you replace the old MetaHuman files here. Once everything is copied over, you'll find the blueprints in the iClone folder, which have also been updated for the new workflow, particularly the face animation blueprint. Okay, next let's set up the actual MetaHuman LiveLink in our project. Over in iClone, I've set up two characters, one for facial control and the other for body control. Camilla on the left is an embedded character, and the gray dummy is directly from the MetaHuman folder. You'll want to ensure that you use the corresponding body type to your actual MetaHuman character to ensure correct motion translation results. Let's proceed to open up the Unreal LiveLink plugin in iClone and disable all of the non-character elements in our scene as we're focusing on the MetaHuman animation. Then, go ahead and click on Activate Link. For faster performance, it's also recommended to go into Quick Shader mode in iClone to save resources. Okay, let's head over to Unreal now and import our MetaHuman character into our project. From there, simply click on Add Source in the LiveLink panel and select iClone LiveLink. You'll now see the two characters in iClone connected. In the LiveLink section of your character details, make sure that the ARKit face subject is Camilla from iClone, and the body is our MetaHuman dummy, and enable the Use ARKit Face and Body Subject checkboxes. After that, we can go ahead and apply the motions. I'll drag in one from the Content Manager in iClone to our dummy character and playback. You'll see that the LiveLink works perfectly for animation. However, you may encounter some issues, so let's take a look at some tips for common troubleshooting. If you see something like this where the eyelashes are out of position after syncing, you can fix the issue by deleting the character in the scene and re-importing it via Quixel Bridge. Once you overwrite and re-import, the issue should be fixed. Be aware that you'll need to reapply the same LiveLink settings after importing in the replacement character. Another issue you may notice is foot sliding due to inconsistent root definition between the two programs. To fix this, we need to open up our character's blueprint and make some adjustments there. In the blueprint, let's manually add a LiveLink skeletal animation component, and then go down and add an event for on LiveLink updated. From there, you'll need to click and drag from that node and add an RL root transform function. From there, you'll want to link the body, LiveLink body retarget, and use LiveLink body nodes to their respective inputs on the RL root transform. From there, simply compile and save, and now you'll see that the animation root issue has been resolved and there is no more foot sliding. Naturally, you can also do facial animation via the number of different facial animation tools in iClone, which we'll discuss in another tutorial. But let's move on to a quick tip for recording the animations in Unreal. We have tutorials that go into full frame recording. In this case, we're going to use the timecode sync feature to record the character animation directly. Here, I'm just recording a new sequence of the character's animation directly, but when I finish recording, you'll notice a strange result when I play back the recorded file. This is because the LiveLink subjects are still active and conflicting with the recorded take. Therefore, what I'll do now is simply disable those options in the LiveLink section. Once I do, you'll notice the issue is resolved. That's it for this iClone MetaHuman LiveLink update tutorial. Again, make sure you're updated to the latest versions in order to ensure everything works smoothly, and keep a lookout for even more improvements in the future. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.